Donald Trump might be a time traveler. We need to talk about this. Now, before you scroll, please just listen because this theory is crazy. Okay, so first we need to talk about this book, Baron Trump's Marvelous Underground Journey, published in 1893. Now, people think that this book is based on Donald Trump's son because there are very weird similarities. So in the book, Baron is guided by someone named Don, aka Donald, and Don tells Baron that he knows how to time travel and they travel to the present day. So that book is pretty crazy, but that same author wrote this book, The Last President, a few years later, and this one is literally insane. So this book follows Don as he becomes president. Now in this real book, when Don becomes president, there's tons of outrage and the world becomes so politically divided, much like Donald Trump's presidency. And guess what? Once this Don becomes president, he chooses someone named Leif Pence to be his vice president. Okay, now let's flash forward to actual history. This is Nikola Tesla. So if you didn't know, he spent his life trying to make a machine for time travel and he claims that he actually did. Now when he died, the government looked over his papers and deemed it as not real. But Donald Trump's uncle was one of those people who looked over those documents that later went missing.
See, on February 3rd, there was a horrific train derailment in East Palestine, Ohio, that is potentially one of the worst environmental disasters in the nation's history. When this Norfolk Southern freight train derailed, it spilled 1.1 million pounds of something called vinyl chloride, an incredibly toxic carcinogen, which is also highly explosive. So as a safety measure, Norfolk Southern did what they called a controlled burn. And this is what they call control. Even worse, there were other dangerous chemicals in the spill, but Norfolk Southern didn't release the full list until over a week later on Sunday, February 12th. They released the list on Super Bowl. They were clearly trying to bury it because the only list of dangerous chemicals you want to read during the Super Bowl is on the side of your Doritos bag. That's what makes the ranch so cool. Now, 5 days after the derailment, people were told it was safe to go home despite residents complaining of trouble breathing, noxious smells, nausea, and headaches. Ohio officials are trying to get folks to come back home, reassuring residents that the air in East Palestine remains safe to breathe. Yes, pay no attention to your lying lungs. The tingling means the air is working. Now, in response to all this devastation, the folks over at Norfolk Southern offered $25,000 to the town. That's the whole town. East Palestine, Ohio has about 5,000 residents. That's $5 per person. Tell you what, sorry for turning your town to a lifeless hellscape. You know what might help? A footlong at Subway. There you go. Sensing that may be not enough, Norfolk Southern is now offering residents $1,000 inconvenience checks. Really? You call this an inconvenience? That's like giving survivors of the Titanic a reimbursement for dampness. Norfolk Southern, I think I speak for everyone when I say, Norfolk you. We got a great show for you tonight.
These aren't storm clouds. This is the fucking shit that they burn off. The fucking shit they burn off in East Palestine. This is not fucking storm clouds. Look at it! This is over Darlington.
Disturbing video where health officials admitted that Israeli authorities had harvested the organs of dead Palestinians for years without their consent.
לא נוגעים שירים שלם את החייל.
מי כן לוקחים?
אבל לוקחים מאחרים.
מי?
אז עכשיו השאלה מי, ותדמיינו ממי לוקחים. בתקופות מסוימות לקחו מפלסטינאים, ואחר כך זה היה עולים חדשים, עובדים זרים.
זה נחשב בנק גדול ביחס לעולם?
זה הכי גדול בעולם.
הכי גדול בעולם?
כן.
מה אחוז התרומות ביחס לאנשים בישראל? כלומר, איזה אחוז...
למה צוחק? כי זה שאלה... מאוד מוזרה, אני לא יכולה להגיד לך, הוא כל כך קטן.
אז שאלה לא מוזרה, תשובה מוזרה.
תשובה מוזרה. לא, התשובה לא מוזרה. משום שלא תורמים כמעט.
Watch this disturbing video.
You're all I'm gonna do. People are freaking out after authorities found over 100 bodies laying inside a building in Colorado. So authorities have found 115 bodies inside this so-called funeral home. A funeral service that goes by Return to Nature owns the building, and they provided a unique funeral service that some people decided to try out in Colorado. They advertised that they do green burials, which means they put the bodies inside a basket like this, leaving your body to rot in nature without doing anything to the body. But when authorities were called, because of a very strong smell that people could smell off the streets outside this building, they discovered that Return to Nature, the company, was in fact not doing green burials, but inside this funeral home that had 115 bodies laid out. According to authorities, the bodies were at least 30 days old because they were so badly decomposed they couldn't even identify them. So they had to identify them using DNA. But now authorities don't know why the bodies were just laying inside this building, and they're questioning if something suspicious was going on, like the selling of body parts that were inside. Because of this, the governor in Colorado had to declare a state of emergency because of how much of a biohazard this is. But it's even worse for the families because now they have to rebury their loved ones. But stick around.
Alright. Story time. So, I've mentioned previously in my Gullah Geechee videos how I used to be into the whole Hebrew Israelite thing. My mom introduced me when I was 15. I followed that for about 13 years. I met a lot of people. A lot of the really famous, popular Hebrew Israelite teachers. Air quotes for a reason. And all of that. Okay, I didn't follow a camp. I wasn't out here wearing Power Ranger suits and stuff like that. However, I definitely was following that, you know, way of life or what have you for a while. There came a time when, for those of you who don't know, there's a non-messianic Hebrew Israelite crew, and then there's like a messianic Hebrew Israelite crew. Basically, people who believe in a Messiah and people who don't, or people who do but don't believe that Yehoshua was the one, or Jesus was the Messiah, and all this kind of stuff, right? So there came a time when I was only just reading New Testament, and you know, your mind map when you get into it, because people are like, you know, giving you a framework and then taking you to different pages, conditioning your mind to see a certain way. And so there came a time when there was this huge debate about whether, you know, Jesus or Yehoshua is the actual Messiah, X, Y, and Z, all this stuff. I was like, wait a minute. Something not right here. And everybody's using Hebrew. Going and researching these Hebrew words and all this kind of stuff. And, you know, and so I'm sitting here like, wait a minute. I'm tired of people trying to tell me what is and what isn't. If y'all are saying that the actual Hebrew is different than the English, then I need to learn the Hebrew. So I learned the Hebrew. I learned how to translate biblical Hebrew. I do not need a translation to read the Tanakh or the Torah. I don't need a translation. All I need is my verb chart and my DDB, Brown's Driver Briggs, okay? And I can get it popping. What really made me stop choosing that way of life was the fact that, number one, I learned that there is no transatlantic slave trade in the Bible. That whole Deuteronomy, it's a lie. It's not there. Okay? I learned that the King James Version is actually a political campaign. I learned that there is no devil in the Old Testament. Okay? Go ahead, drop your verses, baby. Go ahead and drop your verses. I can tell you there is no devil in there.
Here it is. My test results. Can you hear my heart beating? Oh, the white man, science is amazing, ain't it? Oh, no. This can't be. It says I'm 102% African with a 2% margin of error. Why, Lord? Why?
Some people in the Triton area of Mobile say a leprechaun is taking up residence in their neighborhood. A leprechaun. NBC 15's Brian Johnson has more.
Curiosity leads to large crowds in Mobile's Crichton community, many of you bringing binoculars, camcorders, even camera phones to take pictures.
To me, it looked like a leprechaun to me. All you gotta do is look up in the tree. Who else in the leprechaun say yeah?
Yeah! Eyewitnesses say the leprechaun only comes out at night. If you shine a light in its direction, it suddenly disappears. This amateur sketch resembles what many of you say the leprechaun looks like. Others find it hard to believe and have come up with their own theories and explanations for the image.
My theory is it's casting a shadow from the other limb.
Could be a crackhead that got hold to the wrong stuff. And it told him to get up in a tree and play a leprechaun.
We're going to get down to the bottom of this. Yeah, still on there, guy. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid, man.
This guy, helping to direct traffic, says he's prepared for his encounter with the leprechaun. He's suited up from head to toe.
This wars off spells right here. This is a special leprechaun flute, which has been passed down from thousands of years ago from my great-great-grandfather, who was...